community halls. We've got two row community hall, and we've got the work on the toilets that's about to start, which is absolutely fantastic because they were thrown up in a bad state. The next biggest problem would be that our elderly and disabled people find it hard to get in here. We've got steps up to the main door, which is the third picture along. There's no handrails there for our people, and the ramp that's on the left is quite pitted, and as you get up to the door on the right, there's actually about a metre that's got no handrails. The doors have no vision outwards. So if you're a disabled person and you want to get into care up halls, you have to go up that ramp. You have to knock and hope that someone inside can use you. And that's pretty demoralising for our elderly population and our disabled population. When the door's open, you have no warning. You have to step back. It's a ramp that has no flat spots. So you're just as likely to get knocked over. In 2016, I'm not sure that really comes up to speed. While it may be adequate for back in the day where that was built, it's really quite demoralising for our people now. We have an ageing population. We're all coming to this. We really do need accessible entry to the main door that if you're disabled you can open by yourself. Another problem is that children playing inside. While yes, we should all be under parental care, you have to remember that you can't stand there and hold their hand the whole time. So when they run out that door, they run straight into traffic. If we had a ramp coming across that front door, that would have a handrail on it, that would filter children so they ran down the footpath, rather than straight on State Highway 1. While there's not been a problem that I know of with children running out, there's not sense of ease when you've got children there either. And while there's talk about it impacting on the footpath in that area is really, really wide. So it would probably come out an extra couple of feet maybe from where the wall jumped out anyway. There's actually heaps of room for it. It wouldn't need to impact on the footpath too much at all. Really upset considered that that being upgraded. Currently the hall foyer is being, as part of the third upgrade, is being upgraded as well. I wasn't aware of that. I knew the toilets were being upgraded, I didn't realise it before you was, so that'll be really nice to see that looking nice and fresh. The TRL domain. Currently, we have a lack of green space for our people. The national average is 15.9 hectares per 1,000 people. Tira has 2.57 hectares, and this includes our domain that doesn't have any use because it's had no entry for the last 25, probably more than 25 years, due to the dangerous entry. We've got that sussed now with our new roundabout. Once we've got the walkway over the rail, we'll also have foot access to the domain. So that domain could be, we've talked about leaving it idle for 12 months to see what usage. If you don't improve it, it won't get the usage, so we're pushing water back hill in that respect. If you make it usable from the beginning, I'm not talking about the whole thing at first, that would be save our kids from having to cross the road to play. As you can see, the majority of town is actually on the northern side. We're not catering to those children. And with the road getting busier and busier, it's not ideal to send our kids over. And while yes, they're walking to school, you've got the majority of children not having to cross roads. That's how they get to school. So it doesn't have to be notch huge, but I would really think that would be great for those kids to have some extra play areas there. Even a baseball hoop would be cool. Seasonal pools. There was talk earlier this year about seasonal pools and how we as a community board felt that the annual passes should be available at all pools, not just here at the heated pools. I hope that that's gone through, but this is just a ongoing case. They're a vital part of our recreation. Some of the kids could play very different to it. Terra Traffic Management Plan. This is fantastic. There's been a lot of work put into it. Thank you, Dean. You've really stepped up to that and looked into that really, really well. Our town is only going to get busier, and that dissecting road is only going to become a bigger thing. So we need to find some ways to get people through our town if they want to get through, and also off the roads and stop in our town if they want to stop. So they need to be able to have both options. It would be easier to do it now and more effective, rather than having a bottleneck at the end and thinking, what do we do now that it's too late? Then we don't have the options that we have now. A lot of things aren't actually hugely expensive to do, but they would certainly help with transit through our town for people and also with people stopping. So I think that we'll talk about that a bit later on with that sort of thing. So we fully support that traffic management plan. The footpaths and crossings. Last year we asked for some extra crossings to be installed and we got funding for a crossing per year for the next 3 years. So the first one's about to happen. There are tripping and slipping, uneven surfaces through the whole CBD. Some pieces worse than others, but the potential is not ideal. We had a walk around with Andrew from Scotty and Andrew Diffie, so two Andrews.